The fact is, you know, 40,000 Americans are dying every year in car accidents. More than a million are getting injured. And then globally, you have over a million people dying. So when you're when that's your starting point, right, there's a lot of ways to improve that technology. The self-driving vehicles have 360-degree sensing coverage. They're able to detect not only with cameras to see sort of visually what things are, but they also have depth sensing, right? So you might have radar, you might have LiDAR. These are technologies that can see where things are in 3D space. And so when you combine this 3D reconstruction that you can do with the semantic understanding that you get from your cameras, you actually do understand what's going on around you, and you can react to it much, much faster than a human can. So in those situations where somebody else is doing something strange, somebody's making a weird turn, or they're speeding, or a person's jumping out and they're not paying attention, this type of technology will be able to react significantly faster than a human would. And it also won't make stupid mistakes the same way people do, because, you know, it's not texting or drunk. So, right? So although, you know, there are very, very rare circumstances where, you know, some of this sort of emotional stuff might come into a play, I think we can get rid of probably around 95% of accidents just by being attentive and not doing stupid things. And then for that last 5%, then you start looking at, you know, really advanced AI and, you know, do you understand people's gestures and, you know, emotions? And that's a bit farther out, but I think we can make at least an order of magnitude improvement before we get to that level of AI.